Hey guys, it's Will. So we're here in Buenos Aires. We got a beautiful view here of Puerto Madero, and this is the view today. But let's jump into the data center market. So when it comes to data centers, the first thing we're going to be watching in this market is that the spending continues, and we're led to believe that the spending is continuing. As you can see, you got more growth in the data center market as AMD has beat earnings, Nvidia has beat earnings, APLD beat earnings. These are stocks that are building large AI factories, they call them, that power the future of AI. So in this company, APLD, we just entered a trade over the last few days. We do have some long-term positions in the company, but we've been covering it from about $3 a share up to $40 a share, and then back down here to $20 today. This morning we were in it, it was around $21.50, and frankly, at that time, the projections, oh, I actually still have it pulled up. Oh, no, that's AMD. We had projections pulled up on APLD, and it was anticipating a 1% sell down over the next hour. So it's been an hour, and it has sold down further since our entry. We saw it sell down as low as $19, and we continue to see recovery. Now, there's a few factors to watch. Number one is going to be the market. As data center spending increases, you look to see the real world usage outside of just the spending. The real world usage shows great promise as companies like AMD saw record usage and ChatGPT saw more usage, Gemini seeing more usage as AI continues to see the demand surge. That on top of the actual occupied statistics of the statistics of occupation of the GPUs that are in the data centers. And so that looks good. Now you get into number two. Number two, outside of the increased spending in data centers and in that market and also the real world usage, you get into the news. So for a company like APLD stock, when it comes down to the analysis of the news, this is going to be broken down into A, B, and C, news, financials, and then we'll get into the charts. So in the news, you got them securing this 15-year lease agreement with Coreweave. That's a $7 billion deal, which was later upgraded to an $11 billion deal. The main focus for the company seems to be around building the data centers with liquid cooling in places where they have energy directly from solar or wind in cold places like North Dakota, and that's what's attracted some investments from top companies like Nvidia. They're partnered with Supermicro, Dell, Intel, and Hewlett Packard. So the news on that side looks good. When you look at the top transactors on APLD as of recently, you can see they got investments from Vanguard. They have investments from Nvidia, as well as some others, including State Street and Goldman Sachs. But just as of recently, they've had more sells than buys. And on the insider side, according to Grok analysis, let's see how it looks. They've had more sells than buys. So currently that makes sense. You see them start to sell down. They pulled back from $40 a share. And the news that came in around that was that, yeah, they're getting some new contracts, but their financials didn't look super, super good. So you see some pullbacks, still seeing some projections negative over the next few. And then when you look at the next 3 months though, most models, including Grok in this case, look bullish. Most models over the next year are fairly bullish with APLD and have double digit projections as far as percentage growth for APLD. So then you get into, okay, that's the news. You know, it looks pretty good. You see them get some new contracts, AI factory here, AI factory there, and they're doing it in a way that's obviously supported by big tech. But then you get into the financials. So while they've gotten the $11 to $15 billion, it's still lagging on their revenue. They saw $64 million in revenue, up 84% year over year and increasing year over year. But still, their revenue is pretty low compared to what you would expect if they're signing these, you know, multi-billion dollar deals. So revenue still hasn't caught up. Net income was a bit negative, about negative $18 million on the quarter. But you do see big tech investing in them, and you see that they've raised money, and just in the last year have gone from under $1 billion in assets to now $2.4 billion in assets as of recently recorded. So financially, they got plenty of runway. Income statement still kind of lagging behind the recent deals they've secured, which could be good, meaning that they price later into the, let's say, good earnings that come out that factor in some of the recent deals that they've signed, then that would push them further. Market cap, $5.34 billion. If they're making, you know, let's say $100 million a year, or they're making $300 million a year or more, and they're holding $2.5 billion in assets, $2.4 billion, and that's growing the way it is, their market cap is fair. It's not bad. It's actually, there was a while there where we were covering them, you know, under $3 a share or $4, $5, $10 a share. It made sense they would increase. Then when they got up into $40, their concern became, okay, can we see that that revenue, these deals show up on their balance sheet? So financially, they've seen more investment from big tech. They are still, though, right now, pulling down, and in the near term, over most projections, next hour red, next day red for the most part, but anticipating maybe next week balancing out and into the green over the next few. They got a support level, key support level at $20 a share here, which we were watching. They did bounce there today, and they sold down to that $19 or $20 range right there, $19 today, and they're recovering. So that's kind of the financial side. When you get into the chart, this is how it looks. You got this consistent uptrend over the last year. You see them, again, making higher highs and surging, and then recently, so they're holding above that EMA, very consistent uptrending pattern. Then they get rejected back down here under $30 a share. They sell down into $20 a share as of recently, and they're still in an overall downtrend or overall uptrend, but near-term downtrend as they're selling down. Maybe they can bounce this level again in the downtrend and find the next resistance around that $24 range. That's kind of what we're anticipating here in the short term. But I also have long-term positions that say, hey, it's okay if we see volatility. Let's look for this continuation of the overall trend here that we saw the last year from $3 to $40. See them kind of continue up something like this, you know, that would be more hyper bullish and have well over 50% margin for profit if they can get back up in the levels we saw earlier this year. And so as they pull down, again, no indication of full recovery yet, a little bit of a bounce around this previous support level that we saw that they validated back in mid-November around that $19 or $20 range. You could see them kind of bounce there today. But so far, downward pressure holding below. You can see that EMA or the moving average below. RSI trying to recover here, and then you see them pushing below the EMA. If you wanted to go a little more into the charts, the other thing you could do is, you know, pull in, let's say, Fibonacci. According to the technicals, when we're looking at the analysis, so over the next 3 months, trading above the 200-day moving average, simple moving average, long-term bullish structure is what's suggested, and quarterly chart shows ascending triangle breakouts, and view up from recent high 21.20 remains intact. Multiple tests without a full breakdown, that's kind of what we're talking about here, as they sell back down to that $19 range. Fibonacci, you're going to go from the top down to the lowest recent low, which again was today around $19 a share. You're going to pull up to where we would expect them to go, so back up into that $40 range, $35 to $40 here. If that's the case in the near term for that overall or that long term, if you were looking for a swing trade, something like that, you would actually not look to enter until you see it break above $25 a share. In the longer term, let's say perfect entry scenario of timing a swing. But very long term, it doesn't matter. In fact, you're probably going to get a deal. Very short term, if you wanted to look at that recent trend, you'd look at probably a bounce up into this range of around $24, $25 a share, which your confirmation of recovery would be a break above this resistance around $21.50. Okay, $21.50 kind of golden ratio on the Fibonacci, which would be better entry. Again, we entered around that price point, but we still saw it sell down. That could happen. We're still in it right now in the shorter term trade. and we'll see how it reacts throughout the rest of Friday and into next week. But overall, I like the data center markets. I think they're in a good spot. Just technical, seeing some downward pressure, support around this $19 or $20 range, trying to hold with the potential recovery back up into that, again, $25 range if they can break above $21.50. That's a 25% increase if they can bounce here. So we'll be watching throughout the rest of the week. Now, if you'd like to learn how to invest in quantum, AI, space, and tech stocks, we go live every day at Market Open. It's the second link in the description down below. You can tune in live Monday through Friday with the first link in the description. You can get access to the first access for AI tools like this. See that nearest resistance that we just mapped out? You could get it. See the insider trading? You can get it summarized. See the projections that I just came up with? AI is already on it and analyzes stocks the same way we do. In fact, we even just recently added quantum analysis. We can pull up IonQ, for example. It's going to do some quantum analysis, come up with the highest confidence time frame. Of course, it's a generation from models like Grok and Claude and Gemini, so it varies. But ultimately, you know, you can pull in the quantum analysis here. Still running. Let's see if it's going to work. But we just integrated IonQ and Rigetti. So if you'd like to use AI tools like this, go ahead, click the first link down below, and that'll make sure you can start using the machine. If you want to tune in live at Market Open, it's the second link down below. And take a look at that. Some of the projections here, when you look at it, according to Quantum, 69% confidence for IonQ. Rigetti may vary. Rigetti's also saying that one day is the most likely to happen here, about a negative 2% sell down into that $20 range. So we'll be watching it, guys. Appreciate you all. Thanks so much for tuning in. If I earned your thumbs up, hit the like button. Do consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.